Hello everyone! Once again, we're discussing the most popular topic on my channel, how to use a Stable Diffusion without a powerful GPU, preferably for free and preferably with automatic 1111. Unfortunately, it seems that you only want me to create these types of videos, because my latest video, which was quite challenging to make, to be honest, about samplers, how they work and how to choose the best one, wasn't so popular. Probably, and quite likely, it wasn't as good as I might hoped. If you would like to check it out, you're welcome to do so. As for today's topics, we're going to discuss possible options for using a Stable Diffusion, including using automatic 1111 in Google Colab. Unfortunately, all possible methods are currently banned. However, you can use automatic 1111 with a ColabPro subscription. Hold on, my adepts of forever free software, I have something special for you. The very nice UI for Stable Diffusion Invoke was broken, but now I have fixed it and it's still available in Google Colab. So please watch this video until the end, and it's actually the best way to support my channel and show you gratitude for my work. Back to the Colab topic, there are some rumors that using Stable Diffusion with automatic may result in a ban, and that's actually true. Your Google Colab account could be banned, but this doesn't apply to users with Colab Pro subscription. So if you want to buy a Colab Pro subscription for $10 in the smallest tier, you can easily use automatic in Google Colab. In fact, I created a Colab Notebook for that, available via the link below under this video, as usual. But the first question when you decided to buy a Colab Pro subscription is, what does it actually mean? Compute unit per month. It's actually quite challenging to explain because it strongly depends on how you use your GPU for generating arts, or maybe for training. But in the case of basic Tesla T4, 100 computer units equate to about 50 hours of using automatic, which sounds like a good deal to me. In addition to the monthly subscription, you can still purchase 100 computational units as a one-time option, and they will also be valid for 3 months, which is quite convenient. However, in my opinion, the best option is to use Colab Pro for $50 per month, because you not only get 500 units, but also additional 400 units that expire in 90 days. So what does it mean? You can just stop your subscription after buying 1 month and have nearly 1,000 compute units for 90 days, which translates to about 450 hours of using Stable Diffusion in all for $50. It sounds like a good deal. At the same time, you can utilize more powerful GPUs for training, run multiple sessions and even continue background execution with a closed browser. But it's still better to start by checking how many computational hours you can get for $10 before making such a decision. As I mentioned earlier, the use of units can vary greatly depending on your appetite. As I said before, I've created a Colab notebook with the latest version of WebUI. It's accessible under this video. That notebook is quite easy to use. Just open the link, run the first cell to install the requirements, and provide your link to download your model in step 2.1. Pass link for lower models if needed, up to 5, then run step 2.2 to install the control net. In the next step, provide the link to VI if needed, and run Stable Diffusion in step 3, and then follow the gradual link. It's that simple. SageMaker StudioLab is another method that allows you to use Stable Diffusion for free, with minimal limitation offering you 4 hours per day, which is quite appealing. I've already made a video about it and it's still functional. However, it's worth noting that some people have encountered various installation problems, but most of these issues have been resolved or explained in the video. Nevertheless, there is one problem to be aware of, and that is availability of GPU. Since the video became quite popular, the number of people using SageMaker StudioLab for free has increased, and resulting in a fewer available GPUs. As a result, there might be some waiting involved and you may need to refresh and wait for GPU access. In my case, it works relatively well and I don't have to wait too long. I typically get a GPU within about 15-20 minutes. There is another option for automatic 1111, and it's Kaggle.com, which provides you with insane free 30 GPU hours per week. Unfortunately, Kaggle bans all solutions for Stable Diffusion, and surprisingly, my solution has also been banned, along with my account, for some reason. However, I created a new notebook that still works perfectly, allowing you to access automatic in Kaggle through this notebook, available on my Patreon page. To be honest, I would be glad to publish a notebook for my subscribers here on YouTube, but I know that in this case, this method will be banned immediately, as they are monitoring and blocking everything, including my account. For those who prefer to use Colab for free and don't want to purchase anything, I have a solution for you as well. My previous method, InvokeAI, still works. It may have been broken for some reason, but I fixed it and now you can continue to use it for free without any limitation. This method is also straightforward. Just open the link, install the requirements, configure your YAML file, or download any model through the provided link. I added this tab because many people encountered issues with the previous method. Then just proceed to step 3 for further details, or refer to the previous video for more in-depth information. For those who may not be aware about Invoke, I would like to emphasize that InvokeAI is a valuable tool and strong competitor to Automatic. It's worth considering, and in some cases it's even better and more convenient. So I recommended giving it a chance and exploring what InvokeAI has to offer. And don't forget, it's free in Colab, so in some sense you don't even have any other options, unfortunately. However, I'm working on creating my own UI for Stable Diffusion, which will likely solve this issue. So in this case, wish me luck. That's all for now. Please hit the like button and leave your comments. And I'm very grateful to you, those very 10% who watch my videos to the very end. Thank you and see you soon.